Good evening, and welcome to Evening Prayer for Wednesday, the 1st of December. Yes, it's the 1st of December. Where has this year gone? But another reason why the 1st of December is important, and it's really special to me, is because it's World AIDS Day. And about 21, 22 years ago, I worked in the area of HIV/AIDS. And only a couple of weeks ago, someone got in touch with me, someone I used to work with, and he said, and I'm going to refer to her as let's say, Florence, to say that Florence isn't too well. And I couldn't believe it, that someone I worked with 21, 22 years ago, someone who had HIV/AIDS, has actually survived. She now has had kidney failure, and she now needs dialysis, which I'm not sure she's getting as often as she should be. But that's because she would need to pay for her treatment, and she certainly cannot afford it. So actually, if we could remember to pray for Florence today, because she's hoping that some NGO, some charity organization will be able to fund her dialysis. And as we think about people with HIV/AIDS, people who live with HIV, and I've seen in the news today that finally today on World AIDS Day, they have agreed that people with HIV can still join the army. So much to bring as we come into God's presence. And of course, it continues to be Advent, this special season of waiting and watching. So we're on page 205. For evening prayer during Advent. Our readings are Psalm 77, Isaiah 43, and Revelation 21. So let's begin. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Reveal among us the light of your presence, that we may behold your power and glory. Blessed are you, sovereign God, Creator of light and darkness. To you be glory and praise forever. As evening falls, you renew your promise to reveal among us the light of your presence. May your word be a lantern to our feet and a light upon our path, that we may behold your coming among us. Strengthen us in our stumbling weakness and free our tongues to sing your praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise now and forever. Amen. So let's turn to our psalm, which is Psalm 77, and it's on page 760. In the day of my trouble, I have sought the Lord. I cry aloud to God. I cry aloud to God, and he will hear me. In the day of my trouble, I have sought the Lord. By night, my hand is stretched out and does not tire. My soul refuses comfort. I think upon God and I groan. I ponder and my spirit faints. You will not let my eyelids close. I am so troubled that I cannot speak. I consider the days of old. I remember the years long past. I commune with my heart in the night. My spirit searches for understanding. Will the Lord cast us off forever? Will he no more show us his favor? Has his loving mercy clean gone forever? Has his promise come to an end forevermore? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he shut up his compassion in displeasure? And I said, my grief is this, that the right hand of the Most High has lost its strength. I will remember the works of the Lord and call to mind your wonders of old time. I will meditate on all your works and ponder your mighty deeds. Your way, O God, is holy. Who is so great a God as our God? You are the God who worked wonders and declared your power among the peoples. With a mighty arm you redeemed your people, the children of Jacob and Joseph. The waters saw you, O God, the waters saw you and were afraid, the depths also were troubled. The clouds poured out water, the skies thundered, your arrows flashed on every side. The voice of your thunder was in the whirlwind. Your lightnings lit up the ground, the earth trembled and shook. Your way was in the sea and your paths in the great waters, but your footsteps were not known. You led your people like sheep by the hand of Moses and Aaron. In the day of my trouble, I have sought the Lord. Let us pray. God, our shepherd, you led us and saved us in times of old. Do not forget your people in their troubles, but raise up your power to sustain the poor and helpless. For the honor of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we continue to seek God, don't we? For those we know are poor and helpless, and it may be someone in another part of the world. It may be someone that you love and you care for here, but it may be you and me. Anyway, we will continue to look to God's word, and we will seek him some more when we turn to a time of prayer. So let's read from Isaiah chapter 43. We're reading from verse 14 to the end, and we're on page 682. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sake, I will send to Babylon and break down all the bars, and the shouting of the Chaldeans will be turned to lamentation. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way in the sea, a path in the mighty waters, who brings out chariot and horse, army and warrior. They lie down. They cannot rise. They are extinguished, quenched like a wick. Do not remember the former things or consider the things of old. I am about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild animals will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, for I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my chosen people, the people whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. Yet you did not call upon me, O Jacob, but you have been weary of me, O Israel. You have not brought me your sheep for burnt offerings or honored me with your sacrifices. I have not burdened you with offerings or wearied you with frankincense. You have not bought me sweet cane with money or satisfied me with the fat of your sacrifices. But you have burdened me with your sins. You have wearied me with your iniquities. I am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and I will not remember your sins. Accuse me. Let us go to trial. Set forth your case so that you may be proved right. Your first ancestor sinned, and your interpreters transgressed against me. Therefore, I profaned the princes of the sanctuary. I delivered Jacob to utter destruction and Israel to reviling. So here we continue to read of God's blessing on Israel. God reminding his people that he will continue to be faithful, that he will continue to love us, to reach out to us, to strengthen us, because that's who he is. And I love those verses where he says that he is about to do a new thing. Do we need God to do a new thing in our hearts and in our lives this Advent? Do we need to know springs in the desert? Do we need to know that he will make a way in the wilderness? So let's continue to wait on that God. And so we we turn from these beautiful promises to this awesome depiction in Revelation of prophecy, that we're still waiting for it to come to pass. So Revelation 21, we're reading from verse 1 to 8. And just like we have been reading over the last few days, this is the depiction of the new heaven and the new earth. When all of these things that we struggle with, all of the pain, all of the heartache, all of the conflict, when that will come to an end. When God will wipe away every tear from our eyes. So let's read. It's on page 257. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the polluted, the murderers, the fornicators, the sorcerers, the idolaters, and all liars, their place will be in the lake that burns with fire and sulfur, which is the second death." He is the Alpha and the Omega. Let's respond to that in our responsory, which is on page 209. My soul is waiting for you, O Lord. In your word is my hope. My soul is waiting for you, O Lord. In your word is my hope. There is forgiveness with you, so that you shall be feared. In your word is my hope. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. My soul is waiting for you, O Lord. In your word is my hope. And let's join in the Magnificat. Lord Jesus, you are the one who is to come, the one whom we await with longing hearts. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. He has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones and lifting up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to the aid of his servant Israel to remember his promise of mercy, the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord Jesus, you are the one who is to come, the one whom we await with longing hearts. So let's turn now to a time of intercession. Let's come to God with longing hearts and all of the things that are going on around us, all of the things that are going on within us. Let's turn to God in prayer. Father, we thank you that you are the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And Father, as you have said in your word this evening, to come to you, if we are thirsty. And Father, as we pause in your presence this evening, we say that we are thirsty, that we are longing, that we are waiting and watching. Come, Holy Spirit, and fill the space. Our hearts, our homes, our lives, our relationships, our community, our world. Come and fill the space. Father, make a way in the desert. Springs in the desert, springs in this dry place. Father, and as we continue to wait on you this Advent, Father, we pray that you will prepare our hearts for that eternity that awaits. Father, we long for the day when death will be no more, when you will wipe every tear from our faces. Father, when pain and anguish and conflict, like that, all of that we're experiencing in the world will be no more, when COVID will be no more, when restrictions will be no more. And as we wait, Father, we thank you that for your promise to say that nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. So, Father, we want to pray for parts of the world that are hurting, that are in anguish, and we want to claim this promise of Father that you have given us in your word today. So we pray for springs in the desert, for a way in the wilderness, for places like Yemen and Ethiopia and Afghanistan. And why don't you take the time to name any other places that come to mind? Father, we want to pray for our nation. Father, the uncertainty, the decisions that leaders need to make. Any more restrictions? What's going to happen with this new variant? Father, we don't know, but you are the one who holds our tomorrows. You are the first and the last. So we ask. We ask for a way in the wilderness. We ask for springs in the desert. And Father, we come to you for our community. Father, we pray in a special way for all of our plans and our hopes and our dreams and our desires for this entire season of Advent and Christmas. Father, show us the right decisions to make. This balance to strike, oh Father, of being a place that welcomes our community in, a place where we can share love and hospitality. A place where we can love safely. So Father, we ask for wisdom. We ask for direction. We ask for peace in these decisions that we have to make. And Father, we pray in a special way for Richard and the leadership team and the BCC, the Church Council. And Father, as we pray for our community, we want to remember all those who are unwell. And in a special way, we want to continue to pray for Ron, for Maureen O'Connor, for Andrew, for Paula. Father, for springs in the desert. For the time when all of this pain and this sickness and these tears will be over. But Father, you've promised us your healing here and now, and we continue to seek that. Father, and we want to bring to you all the others who are on our hearts and minds. Father, this evening I want to bring to you Florence and so many others with HIV/AIDS. Father, we ask for life. Father, we pray that just because someone has an HIV diagnosis, oh Father, that will not mean a death sentence. But Father, we pray for life. And Father, as I remember Florence in a special way, I pray, oh Father, that you will make a way in the wilderness, that there will be some place that will be able to sponsor her dialysis treatment. And Father, we continue to offer ourselves up to you this evening. Father, thank you that you know each one of us, that you desire to be close to us. And Father, as we continue to wait and to watch, we pray that you will, for each one of us, Father, that you will make a way in the wilderness. That you will continue doing a new thing in our lives. Hear our prayer, for we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's continue to revel in his presence, in his love and his grace, as we worship and as we listen to the song that's called God Who Listens.
The God who made the winters and the summers, the one who put the stars all in their place, the only one who stands above all others, he knows me by name. The angels hide their faces in his presence. Demons run for cover when you speak. You rule the world and reign above all heavens, and still draw close to me. And when I close my eyes, I know that I'm not just hoping, I'm not just wishing. I know I'm praying to a God who listens. I know he hears me. I know he's living. Yes, I am praying to a God who listens. He walks with me and leads me by still waters. I lay my troubles down at his feet. It's amazing that the Savior and the Father, he is a friend to me. How can it be, oh, I'm not just hoping, I'm not just wishing, I know I'm praying to a God who listens, I know he hears me, I know he's listening. Yes, I am praying to a God who listens. You're a God who listens, and who knows me, who loves me, who never will fail me, who tells me that I may soar. You surround for me, so I can boldly to your throne. I'm not just hoping, I'm not just wishing, yes, I am praying to a God who listens. Oh, what a promise that we've been given. Yes, we are praying to a God who listens.
And our collect for this evening. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son Jesus Christ came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord, when he comes, find us watching and waiting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. It's been wonderful to wait and watch with you during this time of evening prayer. And as you go through the rest of the evening, may the one who is the Alpha and Omega be with you. God bless you. And Vicky will be leading us live with morning prayer tomorrow.